traffic turnaround. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. One way to two way, State Street and High Street in Portland could see some major changes in the coming months. The City Council Committee is considering converting State Street and High Street into two way streets, but the planning is still in the very early stages. News 8's Aly Myles joins us now live from State Street with all the details. Aly.
Yeah, Tracy, this is just one street that could see some big changes if this plan goes through. Now, right now, it's in the very, very early stages, but just the research to see if this plan could work is already pretty costly.
It's a potential plan that could affect thousands of people every day.
Task six sort of really begins to kind of look at the analysis of what it means.
The committee is still trying to decide if making two very popular streets two-way is the best course of action.
Hoping you can define a few terms just so we're comfortable.
As the director of public services, Mike Babinski, says the conversion could make the city safer.
As the city evolves with more mixed use, housing, retail, commercial, we need to be prepared for what that looks like and how the impacts of that on our transportation system.
Decades ago, both streets were two-way. That was changed to help traffic flow quicker. Now Babinski says times have changed and the city needs to change with it.
The opportunity to go from one-way to two-way has the ability to, I think, enhance the safety, look at speed, rather than motorists just using the corridor as a through corridor to go through our city.
But the price tag is hefty. Just for the research to determine if this is the best action, it's $150,000. And that's a price residents say they aren't willing to pay.
It doesn't really need to be changed at all. It's just fine the way that it is.
It works just fine. I shouldn't try and change it.
I mean, honestly, I don't really see the point because, like, it's Portland, so it's so close together that I don't really see a point in it becoming a two-way.
Now, the plan still has to be approved by council and worked into the budget for 2014. Babinski says if all of that happens, then the public forum will be created and the public will be allowed to speak their mind. Reporting live in Portland, Aly Myles, News 8.